kind thanks go to Brilliant for sponsoring today's episode. Today I'll explain to you what exactly SpaceX is building at the launch site right now and where they will stack Starships on top of Super Heavy boosters rather soon. On top of that, you're in for the footage of the year as we watch Perseverance land on Mars in full HD.
What about it? Go for launch.
We're go for launch. Let's light this candle.
Ignition sequence start.
My name is Felix, and I am your host for today's episode of What About It? And as always, there's been a lot going on in the space industry lately, so let's dive right in. Starship updates. SpaceX's mission in Boca Chica, Texas is clear. Build a spacecraft that can get as much equipment and people to Mars as possible to be able to build our first colony on another planet. It's a goal straight out of a sci-fi movie. And we are able to watch it unfold pretty much live. Thanks to people like Mary from NASA Spaceflight, Dayton Costlow or Mauricio from RGB Aerial Photography, whose awesome work you're looking at right now. The dedication from countless space enthusiasts to bring us all these images is mind-blowing. Without them, we'd be in the dark. So thank you from all of us for all that you do. You rock. Mauricio has done yet another one of his awesome flybys, capturing SpaceX's latest progress from a viewpoint you can only get from above. Support him on Patreon, follow him on Twitter, make his next flight a bit easier by pitching in. Looking at it from his view almost makes the scenery look calm. A Starship prototype resting on one of the two test stands. Test tank 7.2 next to it. A few cars here and there and a fuel farm to support the testing, there's not much going on here. Zooming out though reveals the scale of the construction efforts by SpaceX. What you're looking at here arguably is the largest reshaping the launch site has ever gone through. And if you've been closely following my channel, you know what's happening here. SpaceX is building the infrastructure to support orbital launches out of Boca Chica, Texas. Terrain is being graded, countless tons of concrete are being poured, and foundation after foundation is being laid down for all sorts of missing components. Looking at the same spot from a flyby 3 months earlier, there was pretty much nothing there except for a graded piece of land and an early foundation for the large bunker. Many are puzzled right now as to how this will look in the end when SpaceX is finished with its construction, and rightfully so. It can be very confusing. With a little help from Mauricio, though, we can shed some light on the construction. Let's follow some pipes, shall we? This is a picture made by Mauricio at the end of November of last year. This was the preparation stage of what we see today. If you look right next to Highway 4, you can see a long line of many small pipes being laid into the ground down towards the orbital launch mount. Those pipes come from the current fuel farm and they are our first clue as to what's going to happen at the new orbital launch mount. On a picture done on January 1st, we can see that this main connection is done and it reaches all the way into the corner of the SpaceX property by the road and ends in three large concrete terminals. From here, SpaceX workers routed the pipes upwards. Two-thirds of them went along the fence towards some curved pipes on the ground, the other third went straight up to a U-shaped foundation. On the same picture, we can also see that there are some large green pipes on the ground here. Those are likely for water. On yet another picture from February 3rd, we can see that a large number of pipes is being routed from those U-shaped pipes that are already buried at this point towards the large bunker-like building. And four pipes seem to be routed from a terminal directly on top of the large concrete foundation, which was still under construction at this time, towards the U-shaped foundation. And we're going round and round and round. Now let's bring all this together into one picture and see if we can get a general idea of what's going to go where. The pipe madness! These are all the pipes we just spoke about. One thing becomes clear quickly. The middle is completely being avoided. Those four large round foundations SpaceX is building on the concrete pad right now do not seem to be connected to this web of pipes. What seems to be very much connected into all directions though is this spot where SpaceX buried the U-shaped pipes in the ground. The link coming from the old fuel farm is going in, and then pipes go towards the large double room bunker, and they also seem to pass it on the side going upwards to the orbital launch mount. On SpaceX's latest update of their plan for the launch site, we can see that SpaceX wants to build two new commodity storage areas or fuel farms, and they want to build a large new crane staging area. Looking back at our picture with the overlaid pipes, the only spot that's not connected to the fuel pipes directly would again be the area with the round foundations. Is this our crane staging area? If so, then what would SpaceX use the round foundations for? They are about the diameter of a Starship hull, so in theory, this could be a parking lot for Starships. On February 8th, we got our last good look at the inside of the large building that all the pipes go to, and we saw SpaceX install large pipes in there. One of the pictures taken also showed a part in transit towards the construction site, and on one of the connectors there's a label saying S2LOX. So there will be liquid oxygen arriving at that building. Remember those green pipes from directly under the area where SpaceX built the pad for those large round concrete foundations? These green pipes do seem to end in the large bunker as well, as can be seen in this picture. Those pipes have a very large diameter though, and that's not typical for a high pressure pipe to channel cryogenic fuel through, so those might be for water. And on we go! Looking at this picture from February 1st though, we can definitely say that there is no piping under the pad on which SpaceX built the round foundations, so it's unlikely that they will be used for any sort of liquid. No matter how hard I searched, I was not able to find any pictures where these green pipes had any meaningful connection. Are they even connected yet, or is this a step we haven't seen yet? Is this the water connection to a possible deluge system for the orbital launch mount? Tell me your thoughts in the comments. Looking all the way back at 2013's FAA assessment for the Boca Chica launch site when SpaceX still wanted to launch Falcon 9 rockets out of Texas, SpaceX spoke about the deluge water system. The plan back then was to draw water from the underlying aquifer. According to the latest plan from SpaceX, revealed by the FAA in December of last year though, SpaceX plans to construct a redundant launch pad and commodities, a redundant landing pad, two integration towers, tank structural test stands, and a desalination plant at the orbital launch site. The desalination plant could very much be for a deluge system, and the two integration towers could be what we're looking at when it comes to those four round foundations, two cranes and two stands. So those four round foundations very likely are not connected to any commodity storage, but rather the staging area for future super heavy boosters and starships. SpaceX is getting ready to launch its future Mars rockets into Earth's orbit. Jumping to the construction site for another awesome news, you're looking at one of Mary's incredible videos. This is a hull segment for a still unknown starship, and there's something very special about it. One entire half is covered with white adhesive and insulation material. And if you look closer at the bottom, you can clearly see a stripe of Starship heat tiles attached to the hull. The trend could be seen for a while now. Every succeeding prototype had more and more heat tiles, and now we might actually be close to a first full heat shield. And what do you need to get a Starship to orbit? Right, a super heavy booster to accelerate it to the needed speed. And booster number one is taking shape quickly now. Here you can see an aft section of the booster being rolled out for stacking. And the common dome segment, so the part that sits right in the middle of the lower oxygen tank and the upper methane tank, is waiting for stacking as well. With the exception of the engine skirt, all parts for booster number one have already been spotted. SpaceX is already getting ready for the next phase, while the current phase is not even done yet. Starships will need to learn how to land first, but once that's done, the team surrounding Elon Musk will likely already be prepared to send the first Starship to orbit soon after. I can't wait to see the first Super Heavy booster do its initial hop test. Next up, Perseverance Mars landing footage. The Y family needs your support. Give the video a like, subscribe, and share it with your friends on Twitter or Facebook to show the YouTube algorithm that you appreciate the content. Gain access to our Discord server where you can meet me and the rest of the team or get a completely ad-free release of each and every episode provided just for members. Or do you know about the Y warehouse? Shop for your next Starship shirt and look as awesome as you feel. Links can be found in the description. You rock. The next topic is one that's been anticipated by the space community like nothing else in the past few months. Did you ever want to see a rover land on Mars in HD? Ready? Let's do this. The video starts right at the parachute deployment. Even though the Martian atmosphere is so thin, the speed of the rover at this stage is still roughly 940 miles or around 1500 kilometers per hour, and that's why it looks like a parachute deployment on Earth at lower speeds. The rover is still 12.5 kilometers above the surface and now decelerating rapidly. Next, we see the heat shield separation. A few sensor cables can be seen inside the heat shield, and for the first time, the camera under the rover is revealed, giving us an incredible view into Jezero crater. Wow! The rover is now traveling at subsonic speeds and about 9 kilometers above the surface of Mars. This also is the first time the radar system on board the rover gets a fix on the surface. The delta of Jezero crater comes into view. This is one of the main reasons why Perseverance landed here. If there ever was life on Mars, this is the perfect spot to find evidence of it. The altitude of the rover is 7.4 kilometers and everything is looking nominal. For the first time, humanity can witness a spacecraft land on another planet in full HD. This view is absolutely incredible. Perseverance is continuing its descent on the parachute and terrain relative navigation is about to start its magic. The image recognition system is utilizing the down-facing cameras to compare the real-time pictures of the surface with internally stored images previously taken from orbit. By concentrating on high-contrast objects like cliffs and rocks, it finds its location on Mars and gives the rover the advantage it needs to land in this dangerous terrain. While all this is happening, the landing engines are primed for ignition. Coming down below 4.2 kilometers, the TRN acquires a valid solution and the sky crane can take over. The white puff of vapor you can see in the image for a short moment is caused by the back shell separation. And since the parachute is attached to the back shell, this is the moment where the sky crane is taking over control, continuing its descent down to the surface at an altitude of around 1 kilometer. Terrain relative navigation has set the course the sky crane is taking and the velocity is now down to around 30 meters per second. Then the most critical part of the landing happens. The sky crane lowers the rover down, hanging on three cables and one umbilical, which still constantly transmits data towards the sky crane and back. Mobility is deployed right after the lowering has started and the wheels get into their landing position. You can see the sky crane move around in this picture. This is caused by the rover swinging around under it, though. The crane itself is steadily going down in a stable manner. As soon as the rover touches the ground, the strings and the umbilical are being cut by explosives and the sky crane flies away to a safe distance to crash into the ground. That's it. The reason why we didn't hear any sound from the landing is that the microphone didn't work during descent. NASA made up for it, though, by giving us a recording from the ground. What you're looking at is the first 360-degree view from Perseverance made with its navigation cameras at Jezero crater, and what you're hearing is the sound from the same location. Right now, you can't be closer to Mars than this. On top of that, NASA has released an image taken by the high-rise camera aboard the Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter right after the landing. Here you can see the rover sitting inside a circular blast pattern created by the sky crane and all the other elements that were needed to bring it down to the surface. The descent stage, or sky crane, landed around 700 meters away from the rover. The heat shield impacted around 1.5 kilometers away. The parachute and the attached back shell are 1.2 kilometers away. This is unprecedented footage. Something like this has never been seen before. And what a show! God damn! It's a testament for how far we've come in spaceflight and robotic exploration. A huge congratulations goes to NASA and JPL for achieving this engineering masterpiece and recording it at the same time for everyone to witness. Ever thought about entering the launch industry, become a part of what you love most? Check out Brilliant, a website and app that makes learning interactive, accessible, and fun. Their approach is based on problem solving and active learning. It's about seeing concepts visually and interacting with them and then answering questions that get you to think. Their courses are laid out like a story and broken down into pieces so that you can tackle them a little bit at a time. No tests, no grades, just pick up a course based on what you'd like to learn and get started. Made a mistake? No big deal. Just check out the detailed explanation. There's something for everybody. Whether you want to brush up on basics of cryptocurrency, quantum computing, or statistics. How likely was a year like 2020 to actually happen? To learn things the brilliant way and at the same time support What About It, go to brilliant.org/whataboutit and sign up to try out over 60 interactive courses for free. And if you choose to get the premium subscription, the first 200 people to join through the link will get 20% off the annual premium subscription. Learn new things the brilliant way. Links in the description. Today's supporter shoutout goes to David Hill, Jeremy Schmidt, Debunya, Jeff Rowey, Rodolfo Bontempo, Philip Bailey, Harley Quinn, Finlay McDermott, Jeremy Arbogast, Frank Young, Jerry Koskia, Ellie Brown, Dennis K., Luca Paltrinieri, and many others. You rock. Thank you so much for all your support. Enjoy the ad-free release and don't forget to join our Discord server. I am looking forward to seeing you there. Today's team shoutout goes to InSpace Trusted JL for being another addition to our website relaunch team. It's incredible to see all of you work on the project, especially because I understand little of what you're actually doing there. Thank you so much for helping us to move the website to the next level and for building a base for the space community. You rock. Hop, hop, hop. Hop to sleep.
Oh. What was that?
Everything still seems to be running. Okay. Oh, look at that.